Okay, so the last regularization technique that is about simplifying the model is early stopping. And it's very simple, as simple as it sounds. We have the epochs and we have the loss. The more epochs, the more times we show our data to the network, the lower the training loss gets. But after a while, of course, the validation loss is going to get higher, or maybe it's just going to keep going straight, right? That could also happen. What we do with early stopping is we just find the point where validation loss is minimum, and then we say, okay, stop, now this is the end. And then you use the parameters of the network from this point on. So you say, looks like at 40 epochs, we learned the most optimal model. Now we don't have to train anymore. If it goes straight, you can say, okay, after this point, it started going straight. We didn't decrease the loss any further. So then, okay, I'll choose this point and we keep epoch at 30. This might be a little bit trickier when we are using stochastic gradient descent, or if you're using a mini batch gradient descent, because when you're training with the whole data, you look at the whole data and then you learn the complete information and then you decide to update your weights. That's why you have a smoother loss graphic. But when you're doing it with mini batch or stochastic gradient descent, which is getting the data one by one and updating your network, the problem with that is you are seeing subsets of the data, and the subsets of the data is not going to be perfect examples or perfect representations of the whole data. That's why sometimes one mini batch is going to help you more to decrease loss. The other mini batch is going to not help you so much, but at the end, you're going to have a downward trend, both with training and also validation. How can you decide, though, at what point to stop with early stopping with this one? Is that you can basically say, okay, here is the minimum amount it looks like. If my model is below this threshold for 3 epochs, 5 epochs, or whatever, that means that this is a good value. And I'm going to take the epoch that gave me the minimum loss under this line. So that's how you can do that too. One caveat of early stopping is something I heard actually Andrew Ng Ji said. He believes that, or I think he and some part of the AI community believe that early stopping is not actually a really good option, because they believe that training and dealing with problems should be a little bit two different approaches. So you have training where you put your data in there and it trains and it learns and it converges and then you put things on top of your model that will deal with overfitting. But what you do with early stopping is that you interrupt the learning process of your network in the middle, and so it's not able to learn yet. So it's saying, instead of interrupting the learning process, add some more approaches or techniques on your model that will stop it from overfitting in the beginning without having to stop the learning process. And that way, you'll probably get better performance. And that way, you're not going to complicate your model too much, because with early stopping, then if you use some other technique, everything is going to be just like one big jumble. So they think that we should keep the training part of the network and dealing with problems like overfitting separately. The last thing is, like we talked about, we can add more information to the network. And how we can do that is either you have more data, or if you don't have more data, or if you want to train your network on a specific way, you can use data augmentation. And that is basically creating different versions of your data to give to your network. So if you want to specifically have your data detect dogs in many different shapes and forms or like angles, and you only have dogs sitting down, photos of dogs sitting down, not moving, it might not be very useful. So maybe you want to also see that it's a dog if the dog is jumping and it's like 90 degrees to the camera. So what you can do is you can transform all your images in different ways. You can angle them a bit, you can kind of give them different transformations to create these examples, so your data will be more tolerant to these changes. Another thing is that you can change the contrast, you can change the colors, you can give it a grayscale, you can make it a grayscale image, you can exaggerate the colors, you can blur it a little bit, if that is the kind of thing that you want your model to be tolerant of. So depending on what you want your model to learn, what you want your model to be able to deal with, then you can decide what kind of transformations to make with data augmentation. But this will help us deal with overfitting, basically because it gives you more data. It gives your model more data that it needs to deal with and it needs to understand and fit. And that concludes the dealing with overfitting with neural networks. In the next lesson, we will go into the very famous unstable gradients problem. So I'll see you there.